Hector, what's the most important part of having to fight a southpaw, being an orthodox fighter, for Jose Ramirez to have success against Josh Taylor? Is it going to be his footwork? Is it going to be...
It just depends on what the other fighter does best. Some southpaws like to jab and use their hook a lot. Some of them, you know, really want to throw the left hand because the other guy's an orthodox fighter. So it just kind of depends on what they like to do. And then you just kind of, you know, clear the guy out, practice for everything, really. And some people, you know, like to keep their foot on the outside, actually train different, actually make them go towards the power hand. So that's just kind of what my training is. But I don't do it with every fighter. Every fighter is different. So
every southpaw has an advantage over a orthodox fighter because they spar their whole amateur career and their whole career, basically. Yeah. You know?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that is true. It may be a little awkward, but I mean, I think, you know, during training camp, Jose has been sparring southpaw, so, you know, he has enough time to really get adjusted to it. He's going to do good.
The adjustments, that's what it has to do with being able to switch the game plan in the middle of a round and not have to wait to get instructions from Robert, but actually be really creative and be intuitive of what's going on.
That's right. And staying focused throughout the whole fight.
That's the hardest part.
That's the hardest part right there.
Virgil Sr. always says that a fight always starts in the 6th, 7th, and 8th round. Like, that's when all the feints go away. That's when all the moving around starts going away. And when you really have to, like, bite down and fight.
Yeah, you really think about it, you know, everybody comes out strong in the first... three to four or five rounds. After that, the power kind of sits a little bit. It's not as strong as the first few rounds. So you really have to use your head more. You have to focus more. That's when people start laying traps and you know, really, really, really making it more of a chess game. Yeah. So, yeah, that's, you know, it's boxing.
It's a pretty good corner versus another corner, right? Ben Davison?
Yeah.
That's over on the other side with Fury. I think he's been with Fury, right?
Yeah, he's been with a lot of guys.
He's been with a lot of guys?
He's been with a lot of guys. You know, but shit, Robert has too.
Yeah.
So there's no one like him and two top trainers, for sure.
So maybe two more years for your son to start boxing, to go pro, or what? What do you think?
Actually, you know what? They're going to go... They may go and fight in Mexico. They got invited to go, so I have like four guys going over there. So we'll see how they do in the amateurs. I know it's a different sport than the pro game. So we'll see how they do, and then we'll take it from there. I got one that's probably maybe already ready. It's Figo Ramirez. So he's maybe on the verge of turning pro. I just got to see what he wants to do after high school.
How old is he?
18.
Oh, he's 18 already. Yeah, I didn't know Figo was 18.
He's graduating this year. He's the 114, the Chiquito, but,
nice.
But hey, he can fight.
Where can we find you on social media?
Hector Beltran Sr. On Instagram, Hector Beltran on Facebook. I don't really use my Facebook, but my Twitter, I think, is Hector Beltran Sr. too.
All right, thank you for the interview.
Thank you.